Hello, we are Mapping Health and we automate the processing of unstructured medical data. Our team consists of Hanif Samad, who is a data scientist. He is an ex-public healthcare statistician. We also have two clinicians, Dr. Andrew Fang, who is a primary care physician with experience in medical informatics and data analytics. I am a vascular surgeon and I've recently completed my MBA. The problem that us clinicians face is that it's challenging to harness and scale the value of unstructured clinical data while keeping documentation simple. This is as healthcare data has large volume and is also unstructured and difficult to extract. We have validated our problem by holding multiple interviews and we would like to focus on the auditor in the quality office who needs to manually review 400 discharge summaries per week just to identify 15 different adverse events. This problem is also sizable and Health Affairs in 2016 did report that more than 15 billion is spent annually just to report quality measures in the United States. Of note, 15 hours is spent per physician per week dealing with quality measures, and it has been estimated that if this were put away with, the physician would be able to treat 9 additional patients per week. At this point, I would like to hand over to Hanif, who will talk about our Mapping Health solution and also give a demo of our prototype. Hanif, over to you.
Introducing Mapping Health, an end-to-end solution that plugs into any source of unstructured clinical data and extracts the information that you need. In this demo, we will simulate a process that is taking place in many hospitals around the world, and that is identifying adverse events from discharge summaries. Currently, this is a manual process, which means it takes a lot of time, and not all cases get detected, which is not ideal. So how might Mapping Health improve on this situation? Let's have a look. Here we have 300 de-identified patient summaries, which we've extracted from a public data set, and that we ran through our NLP engine or natural language processing. Now, the first thing that can happen is that with the click of a button, we are automatically able to filter the number of cases of potential adverse events. As you can see, we have roughly half the number of cases, and we do this through a combination of keywords and rules for these adverse events. Now, does this mean that the system is perfect and that all of these cases are actual adverse events? Well, the answer is no. We know that patient cases can be complex, and that is why we have built a human-in-the-loop module that enables the clinician to verify these cases with their expert knowledge. And they're able to do this through powerful contextual attribution of these cases. So for example, it's not just renal failure, but acute renal failure that identifies this patient for a potential case of acute dialysis. Likewise, for the adverse event of DVT or deep vein thrombosis, this is where a patient runs the risk of a blood clot due to a recent surgery. We have actually enhanced the NLP to be able to identify temporal attributions. So in this case, as you can see, this patient was flagged for multiple surgeries, but we note that all of them were done in the past. In addition, we integrate standardized clinical terminologies such as SNOMED CT that enable precise data definitions of the identified clinical concepts. This is very useful. For example, if you're building a registry or if you intend to use the high quality data that has been curated as the basis for a future AI model. In summary, there are four components that make Mapping Health an end-to-end solution: automatic de-identification, recognition of clinical concepts, including diagnoses and procedures, powerful contextual attribution of those concepts, including temporal attributions, as well as an integrated data model that uses standardized clinical terminologies. So why choose Mapping Health? We have surveyed the competitor landscape, and we find that our human-in-the-loop module, as well as bespoke elements, distinguish us from our local and regional competitors. In fact, we have found a company called Carta Healthcare, based in San Francisco, which is trying to do something very similar to us, except that, of course, we have the localized knowledge for this market. In fact, if you'll notice, Carta is the Latin word for map. So apparently, we were not the only ones who were thinking of Mapping Health. Over to you, Eunming.
This is our B2B model, and we'll focus on EMR providers and healthcare providers as our customers. Our UVP is that we are interoperable, and we will be EMR agnostic. We will also work on a subscription model. For next steps and requests, we would like to improve our hybrid NLP engine and develop our automatic de-identification model. Please collaborate with us. We are looking for early adopters with use cases and also other developers who are interested in joining us on our journey. In summary, this is a big opportunity in the healthcare data processing market. We have a unique product and we also have a strong team with some clinical expertise. We request to link up with early adopters to validate our solution in a real-world problem. Contact us at maphealth.io. Thank you.